Happy to see you all. I hope are you all sitting okay? Good, good, good. Thanks for having me here. That should be the first things I should say. I came from Denmark yesterday, and I've been. I saw this is my first time at C33, or C sorry, C3. So I've been working hectically on making this presentation. I have not been showering, but I promise I'm pretty decent normally. So this talk is about empowering rural Africa using Freifunk. I'm very enthusiastic about Freifunk, and I have a deep reverence for the community and the ability to make such a technology. In a volunteer organization, I would have liked to be more involved, and I would like to be more involved, and that's also why I'm here. But previously, I haven't had the time until now. So let me just start by introducing myself here. So, in my day job, I'm a software test engineer. I sit with my computer and test other people's stuff. That takes the most of my time. Then I have also been managed to start my own enterprise or company. This is my second company, Tribe Group. My first one was called Samsuel. Yeah, this one. But yeah, enough about me. Tribe Group, I started this. It's kind of the same reason why I started my first project, to try and help people. That's pretty much it. I'm trying to help other people, and now I'm doing it in a corporate environment, trying to work on it professionally in some way. So you see, that's kind of the overall yeah, topic of Tribe Group and what I'm planning to do with that. So I think what you can see is that September 2018 is like what is it, 3 months old, and I've been busy with two full-time jobs in the meantime. So I haven't. This is kind of the first attempt at making an international corporation. This is where I am. This is in Copenhagen, on Amager, and you are all very welcome to come by. This is the office of Tribe Group and the first co-working space, Workhive, which I'm also managing, which is a yeah, it's a co-working space. It's a small-scale co-working space, maximum 15 people. What do you call it? With room for everyone. The idea is, in the long term, to create a carbon negative co-working space, a carbon negative and inclusive and flexible co-working space. Because in Copenhagen, there's a lot of there's of course a lot of co-working spaces, and you have to pay like 3 months deposit in advance to get any chance of getting there, and it's all very mainstream, and I don't like it. So that's why I made my own. But so, Fanswam Foundation is a Nigerian NGO that started in 1996 with the goal to eliminate poverty and disadvantage through integrated development programs. And I came to know about Fanswam just, yeah, 3 months ago through a friend in Copenhagen. I was studying at ITU, and there was another teacher there called named Sebastian, who was part of the Freifunk community and part of APC, who had different projects around Africa in providing wireless networks for developing countries. So, and because I'm part Danish and I'm part Nigerian, so to make things a little easier for myself, I think I'll just try. Go for something in Nigeria where I already have some connections. So this is the place where the Fernsehen Foundation is located, down here, yeah, Abuja. That's the capital of Nigeria. And then you have Kano. That's another big city in Nigeria. And then on top of that, you have the Saharan desert and a lot of other countries. So you see that Fernsehen Foundation is based in a rural location, and that is, I mean, that's the goal of their business. That is to empower the rural population. And they keep their words in that way. They were originally they were based in Jos back in 1996, but Jos is another big city. They have fiber and they have internet, stable electricity, a lot of all the fancy amenities of life. But then they moved. They moved out here in the middle of nowhere because that's how they work. That's the purpose of all of this. That is to get the unconnected connected. This is the current building. They have one building and they have 250 workstations. Those workstations, I mean, they have some workstations and some laptops. What you see here is it's a thin client. I think it's custom made, but I don't know enough of that right now. I'm getting in contact with the guy who helped set up this workstation environment. But like HP has some thin client products, but I don't think this is an HP product. I think this is a custom made solution. So the idea with a thin client is that you have one server with a lot of computing power, and then you have a lot of screens that just all connected to the server. So you pull out your, in this case they use Windows 10 on the server, but I would of course recommend Linux, but that's another talk. And then everyone has access to computing power. The challenge, the reason why they are doing it this way is because of electricity. To have a full station desktop is like 70 watts or something, but to have a thin client like this one is only 10 watts. So, and their electricity is provided by solar or the grid or diesel generators. So there's these three sources of power, and they're all kind of like juggling. They're just coming on and off. So the problem is the limited internet access, and it's a problem with the three dimensions. It's a problem about government policy, and it's a problem about technical capacity and capability, and then it's a problem about financial capacity. And underlying all these is, of course, knowledge of how to navigate, how to create internet access, juggling these three things. In relation to government policy, there's a movement in Africa about TV white space, using the TV white space wavelengths to provide more long distance internet coverage. But that's still something that's going on, ongoing. Yeah. So the aspect that that I'm trying to work at together with Fernsehen is more around the technical capacity and knowledge. It's like working in this area. I'm not really involved with the government. Yeah. This is a map of internet usage in Nigeria. It's old. It's 2006, but it hasn't. Yeah, it's changed a little bit. This is a map of literacy rate. Niger is the country above Nigeria, in the located in the Saharan desert, and up here we have the Denmark and Germany. I don't want to go into that. Corruption, yeah. About the government, people in Nigeria don't really trust the government, and that's what this index shows. Unemployment, pretty high unemployment compared of any of the only South Africa. I think it's South Africa over here. They have a higher unemployment in the African continent. But yes, of course, this talk was titled "Empowering Rural Africa," but the problem of internet access in rural areas is not isolated to Africa alone. And as you see, it's a bigger problem in the Asian countries, where you have sometimes like 18% internet access in Pakistan. So in that regards, Africa is a bit doing well, but not as big as well as it could, of course. So what is the solution? The solution is connected community networks. A community network is. Are any of you familiar with participatory design? Good. Participatory design is about involving all your stakeholders in creating a solution that everyone is okay with. So a community network is about creating that framework for everyone to get engaged and involved in creating a solution together. And then, of course, in that regard, we want secure community Wi-Fi and a. Sorry, I've got to mention one thing. The point here about community Wi-Fi and secure, you should say why even focus on that in at all? But I think you know it's a problem of censorship, and it's a problem of sometimes, I don't know if you know, but in the last 5 years, there's been more than 10 events where countrywide or regional internet access has just been shut off from the government in around different African countries. So Cameroon was a big example back in 2000, yeah, last year, 2017. The English-speaking part of Cameroon was without internet for 3 months during election. And that's millions of people without any internet, millions of businesses without internet. Yeah, the same thing happens in Togo. And that's why I want to create some more secure and unstoppable Wi-Fi. So the value proposition is that we are trying to create a positive feedback system where we provide free community using Freifunk technology as much as we can. That's where I need other people's involvement, because I'm not a super hacker in that sense yet. And then we provide free facilitation or education, teaming up. I'll create kind of a volunteer group where, I don't know, it's just a knowledge exchange. It's a platform where people who have who need help can ask others for help. Okay. And then the business aspect. the first two things are this: it's creating the community and the Wi-Fi, and then you should ask like, how do I get the money? How do I get the money to do that? And Fansuam is an NGO, and they do fundraising and get help in that way. But I don't have any experience with fundraising, and I've been a volunteer for a long time, but the company that I've made, Tribe Group, right now, that's not an NGO, because I just don't know how to make that work. So, because I don't know how to do fundraising, but of course I could look into that also. So the idea is to create a portal where, like Fiverr, where people can sign up for microwork and they can get payments to their mobile bank accounts. And then in that portal, I mean, if they use that portal, then we will take 20% of, 10% of the transaction on the portal to reinvest in the system and to provide more coverage and essentially to provide more growth of the community Wi-Fis in Nigeria and in other parts of Africa, which was the original goal. The reason to use that approach, that's a business-oriented approach. That's because of speed. And I'm kind of impatient, but that's kind of just my personal inclination. So I would like to get this thing moving as fast as possible. And I don't have the patience to be spending months writing fundraising applications left, right, and center. So I'm trying to create a system that where the different processes will reinforce a positive feedback to create this growth of community networks and community Wi-Fi infrastructure as a service. That was actually it. So now it's open for questions. Thanks.
Thanks. Super interesting talk. You mentioned a few really cool things like participatory design and different stages of digital divide, if I understand correctly. But then you went very quickly to the solution, which is the network. Can you explain a little bit more about the network? Because I think I just missed the connection of what the network does and how it solves the problem.
Do you mean the community network, the Wi-Fi network?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, it's of course, it's a, what do you call it? It's a thesis. I'm making a hypothesis. Hypothesis that by creating a basis of Wi-Fi, Wi-Fi access, Wi-Fi network, then at least there will be an incentive for people to learn more, or a platform for people to even get the knowledge in the first place. But it's also a very good point, and I think I have a slide somewhere. Okay, I didn't get that one. Okay, but. Yeah. Okay, 56% of the population cannot afford a mobile phone. But this one is very interesting. 40% don't know what the internet is, and 22% of those who have access to the internet don't know how to use it. So, of course, the community network, the infrastructure in itself is just an infrastructure. It's a neutral technology. So if people don't know how to use it, it's still not engaging. So that's where the other part of the solution. the knowledge hub and the community chat. That's I kind of see that as a as I want to make a platform where people like me and you can interact with people who don't know anything about the internet, because you know the internet is big, and it took me like 30 years to understand anything about it. So to think that that people who have never even heard about the internet should just sign up and then start using it as a normal person, whatever that is of course what they call it. I can't remember the name. Okay. Does that answer the question?
Yes.
Okay.
Kind of.
Thank you.
Okay, last question.
I'm not really familiar with the Freifunk model myself. Could you expand a little bit on how that works?
Yeah. Well, the Freifunk, maybe. Okay, the Freifunk model is a community Wi-Fi network where people. It's a mesh Wi-Fi network where people provide their own. What do you call it? Sorry?
There are a lot of Freifunk people here at the Orbit. You can ask them about networking, and Freifunk itself is a free and self-organizing network, Wi-Fi network, based on a cheap OpenWRT based routers.
Yeah.
And so it's the really short explanation. If you need more information, just ask the people outside on the tables.
And it's a very inspiring solution, Freifunk community, because they are working to provide free internet for everyone, free and safe, and those combinations are just very difficult to match up, and I envision, especially in a German context, because of regulation, and also in Denmark because of the regulation, it's difficult to provide free and secure and safe internet access for everyone, for the public.
Very last question.
So, as far as I understand, there will be operational costs for this Freifunk to not only to buy these routers, but to operate them, to maintain them, to get the internet access. How is this planned to cover?
So how to cover all the costs?
Not only the cost, but also you need maybe some persons who can do this. They must be trained.
Yeah. That's with my company, I'm putting in some investment capital to try to create a starting point. And then with regards to the training, it's all has to be, right now I envision it as kind of an ad hoc self-organizing group. So I'm creating these two groups, one on Keybase, which is a very, very good platform, and then one on WhatsApp, because like it or not, all of Africa is on WhatsApp, because Facebook has just taken over all the networks. So everyone has, even people who don't have internet access, they have WhatsApp access, because that's the power of Facebook in Africa. So I'm setting up a WhatsApp group and a Keybase group to connect people in Africa with people here to do the knowledge transfer that is necessary to make the network stable and functioning. That's the idea.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.